So hello everyone, I'm Anushka Jha and I welcome you all to AdGilly's segment, that is the Marketers Unplugged. And today with us we have Riddhi from the Teeds team. Hi Riddhi.
Hi Anushka, thanks for having me here.
Okay, so firstly, would you like to walk us through what Teeds exactly is and what does it do with the product prospect and what are the areas they are trying to expand? If you could just walk us through about it.
Sure. So we launched Teeds in India last year officially, but Teeds has had a global presence since 2011. We are actually the pioneers of outstream video globally. So back in 2011, when YouTube and in-stream video was the only sort of way advertisers would utilize video as a channel to have their messages reach the audience, Teeds found something that can be placed within the editorial content or within the heart of premium editorial content. And this is how outstream video was actually born. So video lies at the heart of everything that Teeds does. Also, creative excellence is another strong point at Teeds. We have a excellent team of highly talented designers and a very enhanced creative platform that has created impactful creatives for a lot of luxury brands globally, and that's what Teeds is known for as well. Other than that, I think the latest that we have in the Teeds suite of offerings is CTV. So we have introduced a CTV in its native as well as in the in-stream form. We have tied up with OEMs such as LG and other OEMs like TCL, Xiaomi, Hisense. We are the exclusive resellers for LG in many global markets as well as in APAC. And we are also working closely with other OEMs, like I mentioned, in markets like Australia, New Zealand, SEA, as well as in India. So we just launched Hisense in India about a couple of weeks ago. Alongside that, obviously, we are also introducing in-stream CTV advertising as something that should launch in India very soon. It has already launched globally. And this is more or less on the video side. We're also looking to forge new partnerships in terms of, driving efficiencies with AI-based tools for creative optimization. We also have something that measures the carbon footprint on your campaign. So we've tied up with Scope 3 for that as well. So apart from the primary video and creative excellence offerings that we have at Teeds, we also have a lot of allied offerings like attention measurement, carbon footprint measurement. We have something called as the media barometer as well, which sort of helps you to measure your creative effectiveness across different stages of the campaign. So, and needless to mention that all of this is possible through our global media buying platform, which is called the Teeds Ad Manager, which is totally self-sufficient. So we have premium partnerships with a lot of publishers globally. We have about 3,000 plus publishers onboarded with Teeds globally, and you can access the supply or the inventory from all of these publishers using our global media buying platform, which is called the Teeds Ad Manager. Okay. So yeah, that's more or less what we do at Teeds.
Okay, got it. So since you mentioned about CTV, I have a question regarding that.
Sure.
So how can brands leverage CTV and programmatic advertising to maximize their impact, particularly during the festive season?
Sure. So CTV has been the buzzword, since late last year and this year. And we've sort of hit it right with introducing CTV with our exclusive partnership with LG. in India. So we effectively launched LG CTV home screen in India in Q4 last year, and now we're looking to launch a lot more OEM offerings in that home, CTV native space, as well as bring the in-stream CTV. So what CTV does is sort of it allows advertisers to utilize their long form video formats, which had sort of lost their way with short form video becoming so popular in the last couple of years. So again, CTV gives the advertiser a chance to sort of convey their messages to their audience in a more impactful way by utilizing long form videos. Also, there is high level of personalization that can be utilized by, that can be sort of leveraged by advertisers on CTV. Because just like our mobile phones are so personalized, these connected TV devices are also extremely personalized, because each user may have their own preferences in terms of the kind of content they choose to consume. And you can actually sort of capitalize on this data that the OEMs and the OTT and the CTV players have with respect to the audience preferences, and tailor your campaigns or tailor your messaging, to that resonates with the audience that, is most suited for your product or your campaign.
Okay. So moving on to my next question. So how do you, according to you, how do you see AI plays a role in PR, that is public relations, and how do you think that AI is going to transform the sector in the coming 5 years?
Sure. In this rapidly evolving digital landscape, I think AI has already emerged as a transformative force, so to say. And as media and communication professionals, I think it has become increasingly essential for us to understand the impact and potential of AI. What I see is that AI has not only significantly contributed by bringing in enhanced efficiencies in communication processes, but it has also sort of enabled unprecedented levels of personalization and insights. So for example, AI algorithms can sift through large amounts of data to understand user preferences and behaviors and draw out trends and patterns, and this capability sort of helps marketers to create more tailored content that deeply resonates with their audience. The other way that AI has been significantly contributing is, by increasing productivity or reducing time that is required to do mundane tasks. Like for example, banking institutions or telecom service providers have already been leveraging AI-based tools like chatbots to address basic customer queries. And what I've read is that, oftentimes 70% of the queries are very effectively resolved by AI-based tools, leaving more time for, their back-end support teams to carry out sort of more important and complex, customer queries and tasks. And they can probably focus on more creative and strategic tasks rather than, utilizing their time resolving queries, regular queries that can easily be done by AI machines. So I think all in all, AI has been this force that is transforming the way we communicate, the way we consume content. It has definitely, increased productivity in a lot of sectors. I think what remains as a responsibility for all of us is to utilize AI responsibly. As marketers and as communication professionals, I think it also becomes our responsibility to sort of communicate transparently to our audience and to our users as to what is the data that is being captured and how that data is being utilized. And once we learn how to do that, I think the sky is the limit. AI is really going to, like, what we see right now is just just the beginning, and I don't know, I think it remains unknown as to how AI is completely going to transform our world.
Okay, so lastly, if we talk, since we are at the AdGillies Datamatics, so according to you, how does events like Datamatics has an impact to the entire ecosystem? And just could you just walk us, what were the key insights you gained throughout the sessions? And yeah, that's it.
Yeah, so today has been all about AI. I've loved, all the sessions that sort of give us more insights in terms of how tech companies or how clients, marketers, and even, publishers have been utilizing AI to bring efficiencies in their processes, create hyper-personalization, and, that I think as we do more and more events like this, I think it's going to be a learning curve for all of us. AI is still sort of in its nascent stages, and we know AI as a buzzword, but we sometimes don't really know the science and the techniques that are being utilized and that are being developed by most companies. So I think the session from Bliss that I was listening to, that was also sort of an eye-opener in terms of how hyper-localization, is being leveraged by AI tools to deliver the right messaging at the right time to the right user. So I think we should have more and more events like this that kind of help the audience and all of us in the industry to know more about what lies ahead for the future. Thanks.
I think that's it. Thank you so much for your insights, and hope to see you soon. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you so much, Anushka.